Franchise fans, as you all know, it's homecoming week for the Rattler Nation. That means the Franchise Sports crew will be bringing to you all the Franchise Sports FAMU Homecoming Special Edition. Every day this week leading up to the game, Franchise will be bringing you all something special. From interviews with coaches and players, to capturing the fans' experience of homecoming. So make sure you stay tuned to our Franchise Edition of FAMU Homecoming 2011.
Hey man, shout out man, Rattlers man, Doc P. Liberty Bulls man, I'm telling you, don't sleep, cause we coming. Believe me, we always gonna strike and strike again, remember that.
We gotta realize that people come here to see us play on Saturday, and that's the mindset that we have, and we're gonna stay focused and stay in our circle, control what we can control.
Like Elliot said, we are really the reason for a homecoming, honestly. A lot of people really come, this is another reason for them to come together, as well as the classics. we put in a lot of time to play this sport and entertain our fans, and I don't think they want any less of that from us, and that's why we're going to continue on to do our normal schedule work week. Because it's just how we are. We always work, and we like to show off our work in the game. We know our fans want to see it.
8 hours a week, no matter what game it is. So you don't change because it's homecoming. You stay back. You fight to make sure that you stay focused and do what you do on a routine basis.
I never really got to enjoy homecoming. It's not as much different. It's a normal routine. Some I'm used to now. After a big win, I'm pretty sure we have a chance to celebrate and go enjoy our family and friends. But before the game, it's all focus.
What were your impressions of Fleming? And what did you like? What didn't you like?
Well, actually, he's a guy that's shown, and what I'm saying, calling, he's beyond his age in terms of maturity and poise and composure. And he's, I don't know if it's fair yet to use the word pulley-esque, but, he has the leverage, he has the accuracy. Once he decides where he wants the ball to go, he has the ability to get it there. And a lot of times he uses his feet not to scramble, but to buy time. You know, he'll slide. All of the time he's still waiting for a receiver to come into view. So those are the, and then when he was pressured a couple times, rather than panic, he just gets rid of it. But those are the kind of things you want to see in a quarterback, because that says that he has poise. You know, he's real poise.
There's a lot more time, buys a lot more time. If they had a success, the other offense had a successful play, we had more time on the sideline to go and discuss this play and find a better way to shut that play down or shut down that player. We knew it was coming eventually. We knew it. We knew they were coming along. We knew they was going to give us some long drives and give us some touchdowns, and then we knew it. Just stayed with them. We never lost hope in them, and we're going to be able to work better hand in hand for each other now that we're all segments are clear.
Yeah, did you like DJ said that's helping? Well, you get like energy back, get that built. We had time to get together on the sideline to go over some of the stuff the offense doing, because they want to come out with something new. How we're back in the dead world. So it's real good. So we good. So me and the teammates, we can have a chance to talk to each other if something's going on, or get a chance to get some little treatment, game, mix, or anything. And just have fun with the offense while they on the field for a change.